Another place where good food is important and appreciated is the dog branch of the Usaroor Quartermaster School. Here are trained the war dogs, canny canines recruited from among the very best of European dogdom to serve with the American Army's most famous auxiliary. Thoroughbred or just plain dog, candidates are selected for brains and stamina, not family background. Although dogs have been used by armies from the beginning of military history, they first achieved their present honored status during World War II. Today, dogs are used to an increasing extent, not only by military organizations, but also by police departments, and as excellent night watchmen for factories, stores, and warehouses. The War Dog School at Langres is co-educational. All students, whether human or canine, receive pretty much the same instruction. There are, to be sure, some problems that are peculiar to the four-footed enrollees. But the bulk of their study consists of man and dog learning to work together. Much of the training takes place on an obstacle course not too dissimilar to the regular obstacle course of Army basic training. The dog must learn not only what to do and how, he must also learn to do it on command. Each dog has the same master throughout the course. 17 weeks are required to complete the dog training course. Instructors at the school are fond of telling their students that the 17 weeks, which is a relatively long course for a service school, is made necessary by the men, not the dogs. The dogs' masters take longer to learn. Dog and master enroll in the school together, take their exams together, pass final inspection together, and stay together throughout their army careers. Love of man for dog and dog for man is one of the great romantic themes of human history. Judging by the long waiting list for admission to the Langres War Dog School, it's a romance that is still going strong. They make a formidable fighting team.